Is having a big fan base ever a bad thing? How can we deal with fans effectively who might be crossing the line in terms of privacy or safety? What about cancel culture? If you've asked yourself questions like these, let's discuss some ways to find a positive outcome when things might get a little out of hand. Let's blast off and get started. Konnichiwa, friends. I'm Jonathan Miller, and welcome back to Jonathan Miller Music, helping you become a better indie artist. I make futuristic and outer space inspired dance pop music, and every Wednesday on this channel, I'm helping others take their music to level two. If that sounds good, consider subscribing and ringing the notification bell. If not, then we have no choice but to unstan. Canceled.
Who?
Anyway, stream Taylor Swift on Spotify. See how I tried to get attention when you didn't do the thing I wanted? Yeah. Let's talk about a few things. Okay, so before we start, I do just want to say that this video might be a little bit more serious than the content I usually make. So if that's not for you, that's totally okay. You can click away and we'll see you next week. But I am still gonna try to keep this as lighthearted as possible. So for the rest of us, I want to make it clear that I do not think that it is the artist who is solely responsible for the action of an individual fan or fans. It is not your fault if one of them chooses to go a little crazy. On the flip side, however, I do think it is a little bit of our responsibility to speak out when we see toxicity, and it is a little bit our responsibility to foster a safe and healthy relationship with our fans as well. So if a situation comes up and you kind of have to say, hey, yo, that's not what we're all about here, it's absolutely okay to do that. And if that fan or fans is not cool with saying goodbye to that toxicity, they're probably not your real fans. And also, please remember that 9 times out of 10, our fans are the greatest people in the world. They're so supportive and wonderful and awesome. We can't do this without them, so always stay humble. But today, we're gonna talk about a small portion of our fan base that might go a little over the line. And we'll touch a little bit on cancel culture, but we'll talk about that in a minute. There's some crazy people out there, but safety first, so here we go. First of all, know your boundaries. For example, I'm very open and honest in my music. Like, I'll literally tell you what a song is about, short of saying names. But I do still maintain a thin wall of privacy as well. And I think that that's something every artist should do for safety reasons. Plus, you're also kind of protecting those around you as well. So some tips for you to have some personal space while also being open and honest with your fan base is to never post a picture of the front of your home. We're in the age of technology. So unless you want random people showing up at your house random times, it's best to be safe. Or if you do a meetup with your fans, make sure it's in a public setting and that you don't go alone. Always bring a friend or someone you trust. So that way, if your fan or fans are really big fans, there's someone to help you out. Going off of knowing your boundaries, and this might seem a little weird, but hear me out, be your own media practice. Think about personal questions that someone might ask and practice in the mirror coming up with answers that kind of divert away from the subject if it's something you're not comfortable talking about. Remember, you never have to discuss something that is too personal for you, or it literally has nothing to do with your music, like who you're dating or what you're wearing. Now, the last thing I want to touch on is cancel culture. And this is the subject that made me really nervous to make this video. Cancel culture is a very broad and controversial subject, and it's very complicated, but a very, very brief description of it is basically when you do something that people don't like on the internet, people can join together in an attempt to bring you down. Again, that's a very broad definition, and it's not that black and white because sometimes there are negative consequences for your actions. But basically, that's the gist. However, it's also not limited to you just doing something people don't like. Sometimes, for example, if you reach an incredible feat like getting a number one on the Billboard charts or winning a big award, you can become subject to other fandoms who will try to diminish your accomplishments by canceling you. And that's really what I wanted to talk about today, because some of your super, super fans might use you to cancel someone else. And to be honest, you have to ask yourself if you're okay with that. So for example, what I mean is, how many times on Twitter have you looked at Billboard or Pop Crave when they tweet out some artist's big major accomplishment and half of the replies are like, anyway, stream XYZ album, or
so-and-so outsold.
Yeah, these are kind of dumb comments, I know. But if you think about it, They're actually using that artist to drag someone else through the mud, only to get likes and retweets. Side note, they're clearly not listening when artists like Taylor Swift, BTS, Ariana Grande, Demi Lovato, etc. all talk about spreading positivity and loving yourself and being kind, or women supporting women. It's sad, and it's a thing that I think needs to change. Again, that was getting a little off topic. Remember, that behavior is theirs alone, not yours as the artist. But you gotta remember that if you call that out, those tweeters might band against you and barrage your mentions with some pretty horrible stuff. So how do we deal? First of all, remember, it's not your job to police Twitter and Instagram, but you know your fan base. If you see something like that enough, you can always tweet out a reminder to your fan base to be kind. And I say this on my channel all the time, it is absolutely okay to support two people's success at the same time. This person's success does not take away from this person's success. Just remind them that that's not what you're all about. Most of the time, our fans are wonderful and fantastic and totally get that. But the internet is a strange and wide place. People tend to forget that there's a real person on the receiving end of their comment. So, moral of today's video, remember that you have the right to maintain a level of privacy. If something's too much, you can say, mm-mm, no more. And you can call out bad behavior if you see it. Lead by example and do your best to make sure that your music and brand is always at the forefront. And keep yourself safe. Luckily, most of our fans understand this. And the real ones at the end of the day love and support what you're all about. So those are some tips on how to deal with some crazy fans. Question of the video, what is the wildest experience with a fan that you've had? Leave me a comment below letting me know. If you want to check out any other indie artist tips and tricks or advice, I've got plenty of recommendations in the description below. And as always, if you found this video helpful in some sort of way, please leave a like on it and subscribe if you're new. I put out new videos every single Wednesday. Once again, I'm Jonathan Miller, and I will see you next time. See you later.